Hi, welcome back to Kosher Corner. Ari Siegel with our second location, Ditmas, on Pico Boulevard. I'm here with a special guest, Rabbi Shlomo Einhorn, who's the Dean and Rav of Yeshivat Yavne, who's going to be joining me today for some delicious food and maybe a little bit of Torah.
Thank you for having me, Rabbi Siegel.
We're thrilled to have you, Rabbi. So we're going to start off our meal with the pretzel. So it's kind of a little like a, it's a bread, but a pretzel, Rabbi. I don't know. I know we all make mezonos on this, but...
To be honest, Rabbi Siegel, I'm not so certain that I would make mezonos on this.
What?
This may be hamotzi. Do you mind if we cut? Let's cut into this for a moment
and see
the texture. Yeah, the fact that it looks like bread doesn't necessarily mean it's bread when it comes to halacha. The fact that it's a, wheat made with a, sugar or flour and other, sweetening substances may take it out of the category of being hamotzi.
Like a pasa baba kismet.
Exactly, okay. That is true.
I'm nervous what you're about to say here.
Myself? What I would do is I would wash in some bread back at the station, and then I'd enjoy this.
And then eat this.
Yes, that's what I would do.
I hear that. I'm going to make a mezonos for now. My Rebbe said to make a mezonos, and so I'm going to do that.
Okay, good.
Here's what I'm thinking. To start off a meal, instead of getting your average loaf of bread, get this pretzel, dip it in a little mustard. It's just delicious. It's a little saltier. It's got that, they do it with baking soda. That's how they make this pretzel crust.
Yeah, you don't want to oversalt your pretzel. That's a mistake. Let me just tell you a quick story. My wife was getting a bagel, and she doesn't want too much cream cheese. And the guy is smearing cream cheese, but he's talking about how his sister, she's ill right now. And he's going on about his sister, Nebuch, but my wife wants to stop him from over-smearing the cream cheese.
Right.
But how do you interject
the
conversation?
You can't. So what do you do?
Nothing. He demolished the whole sandwich. What do you get? She had to take it as
is. But she could scrape it off that.
Well, yeah, no one wants to do that.
So, Rabbi, it's interesting. The feedback I got on my last video, great. Everyone loved it. People went and tried the food I suggested. People wanted some healthier options. So what I've decided to do moving forward is show some healthier options. Now we're gonna start with a couple appetizers that can really stay within your diet, but also be delicious. And we've got the Brussels sprouts. You can see they're crispy. Not a lot of places have Brussels sprouts. Again, I don't wanna get into necessarily the halachic issues here, but I know there's questions about the kashrus of Brussels sprouts.
It's tough to clean. They're tough to clean, but these are definitely, you're good to go here.
We also here have the salmon pokey. It's kind of like a sushi, a raw, salmon treatment here with some, they've got like crisp rice on top and avocado, really looks delicious, some red onion there.
This is a Ditmas take on ceviche.
Interesting.
Their own twist.
All right, so let's try it together, Rabbi. Yeah, we'll get in here. Let's try the Brussels sprouts.
It's got a nice crunch.
It does have a nice crunch. All right, let's try the pokey. One of our challenges in our community, Rabbi, is people eating out of fish restaurants.
Ooh, it's excellent.
People saying the fish is not high quality here.
Excellent. This is high quality fish. You can tell by the texture and the color. It's fresh and it's bold and it's...
Oh. I'll tell you what I like about it. And you tell me if you agree. It's the red onion. There's a little red onion and a small pepper here, like a pickled pepper.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of layers of flavor there.
It's very sophisticated. It's like learning a Gemara and Ksubos with tosfos. You'll experience it on one level.
Yeah.
Great. But then once you get in, it's like, there he comes. Rashi, there he comes. Coming at you. That's what it's like.
All right, healthy people. We did it. Now it's time for us a little unhealthy. We got the famous onion rings, beer battered onion rings. So the beer batter is what gives it its kind of lightness, the bubbles, the air mixes with the batter and it gives it its flakiness. It's got this crispiness. Whoop.
Drop that sucker.
I'll share one with you. Ordinarily I eat a whole portion myself. So you got that crispiness, you can hear it crisping. And they have a chipotle mayo here.
I will say this. In the airplane, they have those pillows that go around your neck. I feel like I want to put this around my neck and just, chomp down. All around till I get a 360.
It's delicious.
Yeah.
All right. This is a signature dish here at Ditmas. It's their maple honey glazed chickpeas, I believe. Rabbi, I want to take this as an opportunity because I think sometimes people get so focused on the minutia of kashrus, the details of is this kosher, is this not, that they miss out on the idea that kashrus is about a mindset. So we have chickpeas here. So these are eaten at a Shalom Zachar,
Zachar, at the birth of a boy, the first Shabbat that you hit on that Friday night.
Yeah.
The family gets together, friends get together, and they eat chickpeas. The question is why? In Hebrew or in Yiddish, it's called arbis.
Right.
Arbis is a reference to the verse of Abraham where it says that your children will multiply. Arbe, I will cause to increase.
Arbe zarecha.
I will cause to increase your seed.
Got it.
Excellent. So it's seen as a symbol of fortuitousness. It's seen as a symbol of growth, of success.
All right.
And in that merit, we enjoy.
Amen. See, it's delicious. And the best part is, I think this is what people miss. There's meaning behind it. We eat arbis, we eat chickpeas. They got honey glaze. There's a little bit of rosemary on here that the chef puts on.
You see, when we ate this, we now, along with that thought, we ate history. We ate tradition, a legacy.
We elevate chickpeas to something bigger.
Right.
I love it.